Hello, everyone, and welcome to No Limits, the show where all the burning questions are answered in the realest of interviews. My name is Sam Veneman.
I'm Alex McClary.
And today we will be joined by our good friend and my roommate, George Shashi. George, how you doing?
I'm doing great.
Put your mask up, Chief.
Oh, my bad. Of course.
We're in a pandemic.
Yeah, my bad.
It's all right.
Insensitive of me.
No, you're fine, dude. George, how are we feeling today?
Pretty good. Yeah, pretty good. 8 hours of work.
Okay. Well, are you prepared to answer the questions that Alex and I have brought to you today, honestly?
Yes. The whole truth and nothing but the truth.
All right, cool. Yeah. Well, to ensure that George has, in fact, he understands the rules and whatnot of the interview, Alex and I have prepared a contract for him that explicitly states everything that we are doing and have the power to do in the interview. George, do you mind reciting that contract for us?
Yeah, so the No Limits contract says, I, Ronald George Shashi, hereby accept any and all rules, questions, and punishments laid out by Sam and Alex for this interview. I will answer all questions honestly and to do the best of my ability. I will do whatever Sam and Alex tell me to do. This is their show, and they can do whatever they want. I also acknowledge that this is the best Flyer TV show, and I won't wimp out of any of the punishments like a little girl. And I signed it at the bottom. So, yeah.
Sounds like a win to me. All right, well, Alex, you want to explain to him the good rules?
So the rules are pretty simple. Sam and I can ask you whatever we want, and you are supposed to answer them, but if you don't answer them, then we have punishments picked out, and you have to do the punishment.
All right, sounds
good. And
then
we will explain the punishment to you when the time comes.
There you go.
All right.
You can go ahead and put that piece of paper to the side, and we'll get going. You want to go first, or you want me to go first?
You can go first.
Kick it off, boys.
All right, come on.
It's here.
All right, George, we'll start off pretty simple. All right, if you could go to dinner with anyone, dead or alive, fictional or non-fictional, who would that person be and why?
That's a good question.
Thank you.
That's a good question. I think Kevin Hart, he's definitely one of those, like, comedians that you could be around and they'd probably not be all awkward and stuff. Yeah, probably that. You could have some, like, smooth conversation with them. You can talk. So, yeah.
That's a good answer.
That was a basic one, but I mean.
Who would you do, Alex?
Surreal.
I don't know. You said Kevin Hart, and I'm like, wow. Like, yeah. I don't know. Maybe Jesus?
Oh, yes.
Jesus would be
good. Probably should have. Yeah. Good thought. Yeah.
Right. You know, just off the top of my head.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. I'll go. If it had to be something in this room, what would be your zombie apocalypse weapon?
Yep. You know, like, my mind just cannot stop looking at that, whatever that piece of equipment there, looking like a pole or whatever. But, like, I just can't stop staring at it.
A pole right next to John?
Huh? Yeah, like, right next to the ladder there.
That's a pretty heavy pole.
That's pretty heavy.
I don't know. I've just been staring at it for the past, like, 2 minutes. So, I mean, that's my go-to.
It's a little weird.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad that you're focused on your surroundings.
Yeah. I mean, so I'm already ready for it.
Always have a backup plan. What would you pick? I think I'd go with the wrench.
The wrench is a good one.
That's basic, though. You gotta think of something.
Ooh,
creative.
I might take the music stand. Just go to town, chop something. Mm,
okay.
I would take Jacob.
Just use Jacob as a human shield.
Our cameraman, Jacob.
Okay.
Right. Jacob the cameraman. All right, George.
Yeah.
You're in a fraternity, correct?
Yeah, Beta Theta Pi.
Do you think that you are better than other people because you are in a fraternity?
Ooh,
honestly.
No, probably not. It's kind of just finding, like, a close-knit group of friends, you know? It's like, you wouldn't think of yourself any differently if you have just, like, when you're in high school and you had that, like, four-person friend group that you had, and you feel like you were better than anybody else because of that. Kind of same thing when you find, like, a close group of friends out here.
So, oh, sweet.
Yeah.
Spoken like a true beta.
Yeah. Thanks. Thanks.
You think
Sam.
He's lying?
He's lying.
George definitely thinks he's better than other people.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Only Sam, though. Yeah.
Only Sam.
Only Sam. That's fair.
Yeah. I mean, so is a lot of people.
You going to ask a question?
Oh, yeah. If animals could talk, which would be the rudest?
Poodle. Poodle dogs? Those things are vicious, and I feel like if they talk, it'd just be as bad. Like, yeah.
As a
They'll
poodle
have, like, a nasty attitude, too. Yeah. You know?
They just bring all that sass with them.
Yeah, it's just all hate. Yeah.
That's bad.
No love.
That's
yeah.
a good one. All right, George. So, like I stated earlier, we are roommates in the same house.
Oh, yeah.
Who is the messiest roommate of the four of us?
Ooh, that's probably like a tie between me and Tommy Lavelle, because me, I'm an electrical engineer, and I leave like circuits and wires and stuff like over the living room, and I've been called out on it, and like, so I'm at least self-aware of it now.
Yeah,
even though I continue to do it. So I mean, that's a whole other problem. But Tommy just, he's a cook, so he'll just leave food out everywhere. So that's like a whole other.
Well, the nice thing, though, is that, like, we're all pretty easygoing guys. Like, we don't really care. Oh, yeah. And also, like, we've just gotten used to seeing your circuits everywhere.
Yeah.
And then just, like, your soldering kit, like, we see that, and we're just like,
I tried to hide it in my room.
That's just George doing his engineering thing.
Yeah, yeah. I try to hide it in my room, but I can't get away with it at this point. It's, like, always somewhere out of place, like, in the way.
So, it happens, man. It happens.
All right.
Do you believe in the paranormal, and would you go ghost hunting?
I do. So I lived in a house, landlord, by myself over the summer for like a co-op or an internship. And I swear there were ghosts in that house. Because, I mean, you're living all alone. Like, they might as well attack you then. You know, like, 1v1. You know? And because of that, pretty scary.
What weapon are you going to use against a ghost?
Oh, geez. I mean, obviously the Ghostbuster kit, you know what I mean?
There you go.
You got to stay straight, you know. But would I go ghost busting? Absolutely not, because, you know.
I would use the Luigi's Mansion vacuum.
I was actually just thinking the same thing.
I mean, you got to use the Luigi's Mansion vacuum. There's no other way around it.
I mean, if we're being serious, if it comes down to it and you're being attacked by a ghost, you just have to accept your fate.
I mean, I probably would. I'd, just cower away. Yeah, drop whatever I got.
So many times where I feel like I've been about to die by a ghost, and I just say out loud, if you're going to do it quickly.
You honestly think that you...
No way. I got stories.
We'll have to save that for another show then.
Make a documentary about it.
Mm. Well, people have to keep their eyes out for that. All right, George. All right. Give us an honest answer, straight up.
All right.
Would you give up hanging out with the boys for a girl, and why?
I feel like I've definitely done that before. I've definitely done both. You know, where I've, it's gone both ways. So, I mean, I guess it just depends. But, I mean, so, yeah, probably in some situations I would. Yeah. But, hey, you asked for honesty. You know what I mean?
George, don't be a simp, man. Don't do it. Okay. Don't be a simp.
Okay.
I know September's over, but that doesn't excuse that behavior.
Yeah, you're right. Actually, yeah, you're right. You're right. I got to keep my standards.
Give me your gun.
What?
I got another go. You want me to go again?
I got one. I think it's going to throw him off.
Go for it.
What do you think of garden gnomes?
So after Gnomeo, after Gnomeo and Juliet, you know, which I definitely actually saw, regret it. Not too fond of them. Yeah, and I mean, I know they're animated and all, but you know, like, it's still a cursed movie. So
that's fair. All right, George.
Do with that as you will.
What is the craziest thing that you've ever done to get the attention of someone that you are attracted to?
Ooh, okay. Probably when I, this is going to sound like real simpy. In high school, I really liked a girl, and that's why I started working out so much. So, I mean, I guess that was like a whole habit that I built off of just like a girl that I liked. But, I mean, I guess because I kicked it off because of her, like that habit that I still do today, you know. Like, I guess that was pretty big, you know.
That's pretty good. Yeah. What's the craziest thing?
Did it work?
Yeah, did it work? Did you get her number?
She flexed the steps and fell in love.
Yeah. I guess there were.
I mean, yeah, no one can say no to those biceps and triceps, man.
I'm not flexing. I'm sorry. So not today.
Okay. Not today. No. What you got?
What would your perfect murder weapon be, and why?
Ooh, what's the one that I know it's gonna be like. Really, like, stereotypical, but, like, that, what's the icicle one? Because it melts away or whatever?
Oh, from The Office. Yeah,
yeah, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, I gotcha. Yeah, see, because that's smart. That's, like, some big brain play.
See, I know what you're talking about, because we've watched The Office together, like
about three times.
A million times.
Yeah.
Or three times. Same thing.
Something like that.
Perfect way to get away with murder, right?
What's
that? Get the body. Doesn't matter what weapon you use. That's irrelevant.
Naturally.
Get the body, bury it super deep, like, facing feet down, right? Put some dirt over them, all right? Few layers of dirt, and then get like a dead dog or something, bury the dog on top, and then cover it up. So Here's where it comes into play. Yeah.
Where are you going with this?
Yeah, this is not related to the question. This is just how to.
This is how to get away with murder.
Well, when the cadaver dogs come and like are trying to smell it out, they'll smell the dead dog and alert, and they'll dig up the dog and be like, oh, they're just alerting to the dog. Big brains.
This is like this is like
the. Don't double cross me.
Yeah, I'm looking at you different now.
Hey, if you get in the way of Alex, that's true.
Sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. I probably shouldn't say that.
That whole like monologue you went through there, that was like completely unrelated
to the question.
Yeah, but I mean, credit where it's due. A lot of thought.
Thank you for sharing that.
Oh wait,
yeah, I got one.
I got a good
George.
One.
You dated a girl for 3 months freshman year, correct?
Oh, jeez. Yeah.
Why did you...
Will she remain unnamed for...
Yeah, she'll remain unnamed.
Okay.
We don't need to bring her into this. Because also, like, I don't know if she watches Flyer TV, but this is not important.
Nobody watches
Flyer TV. Neither him Yeah.
True. Why did you spend more time playing Call of Duty than talking to her?
Hey,
well, I mean, the zombies grind is, like, something else, you know? And Black Ops 4 had just come out. I got the season pass, you know. Priorities. I'm going to hell for that.
That's on Bible.
That's on God.
I know.
No, true story though. Freshman year, when George and I, we lived in the same floor of Founders, and every time I would come in there, and his girlfriend was in there, she would just be watching him play Call of Duty for like hours.
It's so bad. He's not wrong. I tried to teach her how to play. It didn't work out too hot. Nope. Yeah.
Hey. I know the feeling.
Dang. Some shade being thrown right now. All right. Wait. Ask a good question.
Brushing your teeth or wiping your butt, you have to give up one. What would it be and why?
Ooh.
Says a lot about a man right here.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I feel like, I don't know how you could get away with, like, I feel like you could get away with not brushing your teeth because, like, people, like, 200 years ago probably did that, and now they all had dentures, you know? I think you could get away with that. I feel like the other would lead to, like, disease.
No, he's got a point, because, like, you can do, like, gum and
mouthwash. Yeah, you got Listerine.
And then when your teeth start to decay, you can just get, like, dentures to hide it.
Can you still floss?
Just get dentist cleanings.
That's fair.
Yeah, but they brush your teeth and... You'd have to say, like, you're not allowed to brush my teeth.
So
think
how
gross
it
would be kissing a girl,
You'd choose wiping your butt, you'd still...
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Because
you
Listerine's
can't go.
Like, still on the market.
You can't go without wiping your butt.
Yeah. I feel like you'd get, like, a...
Infection.
Yeah, like, something really bad. Anyways, yeah.
All right, George. What's the most embarrassing thing you've done in college so far?
Ooh, okay. That's actually a good question. I've been pretty, like... self-control and I feel like it had to be something related to like telling you about the survey.
That's a good
You want to tell that story right now, because that's like, you want to set the scene there, because you can probably
what the one over the summer, because you've done this multiple times.
Oh yeah, I know, and I just haven't learned my lesson
this
yet.
Is true. So basically George's go-to pickup line with females is, hey, do you want to fill out a survey? And it's like, and he shows him his phone, it's an open contact information thing where they can put their name and their number. I respect the grind, I respect the hustle. How can you not? But over the summer, George did it, we were at Art Taco, and George did it to like, I don't know, I think she was like, she's probably an upperclassman, I don't really know. And literally,
Cougar Hunter.
You got her number, and then immediately after we left, you texted her, which you shouldn't do, and you said, before we left, you said, hey, I know this is probably your fake number, but can I get your fake Snapchat too? And she literally texted you back saying, stop.
Yeah, that happened. And that probably was the most embarrassing situation, because you guys were all there for that, just
really
to experience
fun.
It. So
that's hard to come back.
I had a crowd.
That is a little tough. But actually, George, he has come back though. He has defied all odds.
I mean, the survey has worked, like...
Wait.
To an extent though.
I mean, listen. Listen.
I'm listening, man.
I mean, 3-4-0. You get the number, so. Yeah.
That's fair. Next I guess question. it gets results, but I guess only to a certain extent.
Yeah, and then I
because
always
how
find
far
a way
does that
to
how
mess
far
it
does
up.
That take you?
Yeah, I always find a way to mess it up.
I don't know about that.
All right.
This is a long one, so pay attention.
Oh boy.
A witch has cast a spell on you, turning you into an inanimate object, non-electronic, for a year. To be changed back into a human before the year is up, you need to be able to get at least 100 people to touch you. What inanimate object would you be?
Like 100 different people?
100 different people.
Oh, God. Okay. Probably our bean bags at our, with our cornhole set at our house. Like, we have, like, I feel like we have somebody come over each day and plays, like, beanbag, you know, or cornhole with us. I don't know how many people have used that, so.
Probably a lot.
Yeah. Maybe 100. Maybe 100 people. So, like, it would, listen, it'd be done already, you know, within 2 months.
I would say a door.
A door.
A door.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, easy answer.
Yeah, I wasn't thinking. Wait, does it matter? Wait, hold up.
You need a door handle for a year.
No.
I mean, yeah.
Wait, can you choose, like, where? Maybe I'm getting too into it.
No, just you got to answer the question as it was stated. You don't need to
I'd still choose that either way, because, I mean, throw him a Taspi.
All right, George. What is something that you can do? You, Ronald Chashy. Ronald George Chashy. What is something you know you can do better than anyone you know?
Ooh, anyone that I know? That's a tough one. Ooh.
Remember, if you don't answer to the best of your ability, or we not like it, we get to do a punishment with you.
Ooh, probably make, like, little circuit projects that are, like, really outrageously dumb, but, like, still work. I don't know anybody that has, like, the creativity to actually do it. Like, they'll think about, I know people that'll think of ideas and know people that'll, like, actually make them, but someone that can do both, I guess that's just, I don't know, my little, like, elementary school brain just had, like, on 8 cylinders just thinking of ideas and stuff like that.
Are we satisfied with this answer? I don't know if I'm satisfied.
That's your call.
I mean, I was stretching it there, so it's on
George,
you.
George, quick question. What's your mom doing right now? Is she home?
Oh, I just called her. She's on a flight from I don't know where back home. Yeah.
Wait, so we probably can't call her then right now, right?
I mean,
is she on the flight right now, or is she eventually getting on it later?
I feel like I should know that because it's like my mom. I don't even know where she came from. Yeah. I mean, do you want to try?
Yes, we
want. She would love to hear your voice.
Let's give it a shot. All right, so basically, we're just gonna call your mom, and she has to tell an embarrassing story of to the camera.
Oh, I'd actually rather take the punishment.
That is the punishment.
Oh, okay. Oh, jeez, I thought that was a question. Okay.
Put it on speaker. If she picks up, explain the situation.
Yeah.
Situation.
We don't want anyone getting in trouble or anything.
Oh.
And it doesn't have to be like a super embarrassing, but like embarrassing.
But she hasn't done the contract.
Basically, it's up to her discretion.
We'll do it. I'm just praying that she won't pick up.
Oh, please.
Fingers crossed.
Everyone, cross your fingers. Hold up to the camera or to the microphone.
Like right where your mouth is.
Yeah, right where your mouth is.
Please don't answer. I'm so scared. If she's still on the flight, like.
You
preached 8:50. Oh, okay, it's a miracle.
All right, keep your phone out because if she calls back, you bet you're answering, man. Cool. All right, well, instead of that what do you guys think? Should we have him do the chicken dance? Or should we have George sing a song from memory? Or should we post something to his Instagram and keep it there for 24 hours?
Okay. You know what?
We
I'll
as
say
a
silent on this.
All right. Yeah. All in favor of chicken dance, raise your hand. All in favor of song, raise your hand.
That's it.
All right. Looks like, George, it looks like you're singing a song.
See, I know that Sam would have wanted the Instagram post because I'm never.
I know.
I'm never on there. You would have
we'll
been dying
to
put something on there.
George. Do we give him the liberty of choosing a song?
Oof, memory though.
Yeah.
Yeah. George, and you don't have to sing the whole thing. Just like a little excerpt. What song do you want to sing? Also, you're going to have to give us some showmanship. That means standing up and using the
song. Oh, I'll sell it.
Yeah,
if
you
I can even know
it with everybody.
George, do you know the song Dancing Queen by chance?
Oh, yeah.
All right, it sounds to me like George is singing Dancing Queen right now. Do you know the lyrics?
I can try.
You can look up the lyrics on your phone.
Oh,
yeah.
You said from memory.
I mean,
well,
we're lenient, it's, man. Yeah, we don't. We're just here because we want to get paid.
That's facts.
And that's, I mean.
Okay.
I don't miss, man.
What's our TD doing?
I don't really know. Mike, what are you doing up there, bro?
He's shouting something.
That was an accident.
Oh, should I look it up on Genius so that we
like
can get
that
the meaning behind it? All
right, Mike, I'm liking the ingenuity.
Innovation.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Wait, are you ready?
Oh, you're going to play it with him?
Yeah,
it'll
be on Genius,
too,
so we can get, like, the interpretation behind it as well.
You want to hold it, like, bring the computer close to that
and
microphone?
This computer's pretty loud.
Okay, cool. All right, George, whenever you're ready, on your cue, man.
Well, let me know when you're ready, and then I'll start the instrument.
Wait, I'm actually
I got
to really
stand for this.
John, go ahead and give him a little bit of room.
All right.
Ready?
Wait. I mean, if I'm not dancing with Sam doing this, like, is it really right, you know? But I'm trying to remember. Okay, no, we got it. You can dance. Can try having the time of your life. Ooh, see that girl. Watch that scene. Dig in the Dancing Queen. Oh, okay. Am I still going?
Yeah,
you got a little bit longer to go.
All right. Friday nights and the lights so low.
Get into it, man.
Looking for a place to go. Where to play the right music. I thought the reading was hard enough from the contract.
You signed a contract, man.
Not again, the music's high. With a bit of rock music, everything is fine. You're in the mood for a dance.
Here comes the hook, man. You gotta.
And when you get the chance, you are the dancing queen. Young and sweet, only 17. Wait, is that one? Yeah. Dancing queen, feel the beat of the tambourine. Oh yeah.
All right, I think you've served your punishment. Hey, a round of applause for George, everyone. That was beautiful.
At a certain point, you start hearing yourself, and you're like, oh, God, this will make it even worse. Okay.
Like, that might be one of the single greatest things I've ever seen in my life.
I heard it, and I just like
yeah, you
I
want a new
singing.
Answer for the
well,
most
I mean,
embarrassing
one of the greatest
thing on campus
ABBA songs ever.
Mama Mia. Pretty good.
All right.
I feel like you have
What's
better
up
questions
next?
Than me now, so it's all you now.
Okay. A moment. You can just make fun of them.
Yeah, that's what I'm here for, but anyway.
Cool. All right, George. Let's see.
Who has better hair, me or Sam?
Oh, Sam just got a haircut, so definitely Sam.
Let's go!
Which I need to hop on that train because everybody in the house,
everyone
everybody
in the house,
else in the house has had
Tommy
a haircut.
And George, or
now
Tommy
they're
and
all
Brian
shaming Bo. Me for not having one. So.
I mean, you got a haircut not that long ago.
I know, but I got to hop
you
on
the
bandwagon.
You don't need a haircut. What are you talking about?
Well, bandwagon effect. I got to do it, dude.
That's fair. Oh, Alex is done. All right. Alex is officially signing off from the show.
He's giving up on
oh, no.
Can I take his seat? Ooh, can I hop in his seat then?
I mean,
replacements need to be made, you know.
No, you can stay there, man. You got a comfortable
You're
seat.
Killing me, Smalls.
All right. I mean, thank you also for saying I have better hair. I mean, it's true.
It's not.
I'm sorry. What's that? I'm sorry. You're not at the desk anymore. I can't hear you. Oh, okay. All right, George, so you're in a co-op right now.
Oh, yeah.
So at your co-op, in any given day, how many hours of actual work are you completing at your co-op?
Actually, that's a great question, because I've had a lot of jobs, and a lot of times I've slacked off, like, quite a bit. But this is, like, the one job where I'm, like, doing something constantly. And if I'm not, then it really catches up to bite you.
Wait, okay. Really? You're constantly doing stuff?
Oh, yeah. Like,
because me and all the guys, we think you just watch YouTube all day.
Any other job before this, I I definitely would have been.
Okay.
But, like, this is one...
But this is, like, an actual job.
Well, would you count, like, listening to music and stuff? No. But, like, not looking at your phone?
Because I'd say that kind of comes with the territory.
Okay, okay. So, yeah, I'd be... Yeah, I'm pretty productive, so anyway.
Nice.
You know, not to toot my own horn or anything, but... Yeah.
But toot, toot.
I'm kind of the best.
Hey, man. We've... On this show, we fully respect and encourage you to...
We're egotistical here.
Absolutely. You gotta brag about yourself, man. Ain't nothing wrong with that.
It's only right.
All right, George. Do you have the best style of your roommates?
Style as in... Wait, what do you mean by style?
Style as in the best... You dress the best.
Ooh, okay. Oh.
There's a wrong answer here.
There's a right answer.
So, I'd say, yeah, on like a normal... Like, if I'm just, like, wearing my normal casual clothes, I got some really good clothes from Zoomies from my high school.
Wait, would you consider what you're wearing now, just so we can get a basis, like, a casual?
No, no.
That's his work.
This is, like, an IT. I'm straight from work.
All right, I was going to say, because if you were.
Not style at all.
If you were going to say that's your fit that you'd whip out on, like, a night on the town, I was about to be like, you're full of cap right now.
That would be true. Yeah, no way. But yeah, I got some clothes from high school that I would rock, and they look pretty good. Yeah, so. But I gotta say, Tommy, when he dresses up, he like really.
See, here's the thing. I was talking to Tommy about this earlier, and when I told him that you said it was probably a tie between you and him, which I would agree with, he was like, "What? No way." But I don't know, man. I think you're up there. Tommy's probably. I mean, he's close. The thing is, though, we have a really low standard at our house for dressing nice.
The man has a wardrobe. Like, if you...
He's a wardrobe. The thing is, we all have the ability to dress nice. We just never do it. Because
actually, yeah, that's true.
At the
we
end of the day, do we care?
No, we don't.
Yeah, yeah, he's not wrong.
But then
I love how we don't even, like, think about Brian. He's like our...
Well, Brian, you, he's like not you know that Brian and I don't dress... Like, we don't try to dress nice. Yeah, Alex, true. If there's someone, like, if you want to ask for, like, advice on... Style, Alex is the guy to talk to.
Oh, stop it.
Honestly.
Stop it.
Oh, you know I'm going to hype you up, though.
Don't gas me up like that. But yeah.
Too late. I mean, people should. I don't miss, man. But I would agree, George. I'd say you got some good style.
Thank you, baby.
Keeping it on the theme of roommates.
All right.
Do you have the most game of your roommates? And by game, I mean when it comes to speaking to females.
Absolutely not. You know why? Because Sam Wiedemann is always caught talking to some... females that have just entered the university on the weekend.
What are you talking about, man?
It's literally like a meme now. It's, yeah.
What, because I know like...
Don't two, even
I know two
it.
First
so
years, so that makes me... that makes
what, the, okay, okay.
No, I agree with you.
We're not getting into it, but... I mean, do you want me to call out my mom or the other two? Because they'll speak for me, you know what I mean?
He doesn't need to because I'm already on his side.
What do you mean?
Sam,
thank you.
Every time I am out with you doing anything, there is always some random girl that you are talking to.
Oh, well, I mean, I'm not denying this, but I'm more so along the lines of George says that I know a lot of first years, which I don't know if I necessarily believe.
Would I put it past you?
Probably not.
No.
I'm a social guy, man. I gotta...
He is a social guy.
I like me.
Be a social.
Yeah, probably. So maybe we got like one or two questions.
Yeah, two more.
All right, every second that ticks by, it just raises my paranoia of my mom actually calling me back. So,
also, George, because you said I have the best game, yeah. I'm going to make you do a punishment.
I'm all right.
Okay,
with that.
Okay.
I mean, you signed a contract, man. I can do
whatever
I did.
I did. Yeah,
I feel like you want to do the Instagram one.
I do. Because I have a picture. All
right, Instagram.
All right, George, bring your phone here.
All right, let's do it.
Anyone know how to post pictures to Facebook?
So, George,
yeah?
I'm going to...
Anyone?
It's a good commercial.
Does anybody know how to post videos to Facebook?
When does ABP close?
I think it's going to close right now. Did you see the video?
Yes, I did.
Wait, can I see it?
Oh, Lord. All right. It's going
That's
up.
That's a good one.
This is a great one. Wait, what should the caption be?
It's funny because I already have that
Keep
saved
Instagram,
on my phone.
Make Instagram casual again. Isn't that right, Jacob?
Yeah.
Make it casual again. All right, George, you know what to do. And you only have to keep it up for 24 hours.
What if the caption's Corona can't stop this?
It might look weirder if I took it down.
I like keep Instagram casual again.
But then it like makes sense.
I think it's funny. I think it's good.
All right. Okay. You want to see it?
All right. Yeah.
You want to press the button and do that?
Wait, no. Show John. Show the camera. Show the proof. No.
Not the camera operator.
You want to do the honors and actually?
No. All you, man. All you.
Oh, okay.
Take care.
All right. Hold up. Should I put a nice filter on it? Make myself look
good.
Yeah, man.
Make yourself look good.
I don't look terrible, but it's not. It's not. Ideal. Oh boy. All right, you know what? No filter.
Put hashtag no filter.
I'm getting crazy.
Keep Instagram. Keep Instagram casual?
Can we just
make Instagram casual?
Wait, should I just casual hashtag no filter?
Wait, no caption or actually?
No, that's the actual caption. Make Instagram casual again. Hashtag no filter.
Dude, I'm such a hypocrite.
I am so glad that you agreed to do this.
Oh my gosh,
this makes
dude.
Me so happy.
You broke my streak of not posting, dude. That's a sin.
George, I'm trying. If you think about it, I'm being a good friend to you right now. I'm trying to help you get your social media presence back out there. And people are going to love the fact that you're back.
Think of all the ladies that are going to hit your DMs after this.
Exactly. And they'll ask, hey, do you know that guy Sam Veneman? Can you talk to him for me, please?
And those people are going
to do you want to be tagged in it?
What? No, don't tag me.
Oh, I definitely...
I do not want to be tagged.
You just said to post it, but I'm tagging you.
All right, that's fine.
Too late.
Then.
Too late.
Go for it.
All right.
Last question.
George, I commend you for that. Thank you for agreeing. Last question.
All right.
What do you think?
I don't know. What's your best one? Ooh, I like that one. That's a good one.
Oh, you're
getting progressively. Progressively.
Why'd you drop out of ROTC?
Oh, God. Okay. Well, actually, like, we just talked about it. Because, I mean, do you want to... Yeah, I might as well get an honest answer. Not me about it. But we just talked about it with the co-op. While I was in, I talked to the recruiter. And I was like, well, so what do we do if we actually wouldn't like to have a co-op? Because I'm an engineer. And you kind of need that if you're about to graduate. But if you want to graduate and get, like, a job right out of college. And you can't have, like, a co-op if you're in. So, like, because you're just constantly, you're on their schedule and you're doing stuff, like by their schedule. So you can't have one when you're in. And I'm like, well, I'm an engineer. I kind of have to have that if I'm going to get a job. So I was out of it the next semester. I finished the semester with it, though. So.
You did.
Yeah.
But yeah, hey.
There it is.
I'm mad. He actually had a good answer for that.
Appreciate it.
I salute you, sir.
Thank you.
Well, we respect troops here at No Limits.
3 years, JROTC.
All right, well, I think that pretty much concludes this episode of No Limits. So, George, once again, thank you very much for coming
on. Thank you for having No Limits.
Yeah. Sam, thank you. Alex, I appreciate it.
That was good. And as always, my name is Sam Veneman.
I'm Alex McClary.
We have John, we got Jacob, we got Ella helping
doing
out.
Nothing.
We got, Ella doing nothing. Thanks for nothing, Ella. We got
Maddie and Brittany in the booth, Perdomo on the TD.
And
outstanding crew.
Yeah, an absolutely outstanding crew. And as always, we'll see you next time.